What's good, y'all? It's your man, Sam, and here at Viral Hip Hop News. Go ahead and hit that like button and make sure you hit the notification bell to get all the latest notifications every time I drop a video here on the platform. I do appreciate it. All right, so we've all been very emotional. We've seen what's been going on. No one is naive to the fact that police brutality is running rampant throughout this country. Our voices are being heard for what it seems like with the protest throughout this country, the rioting throughout this country. The making the noise is beginning to take some effect, even though in small doses, you're beginning to see some type of change. Now, Lil Wayne was on Fat Joe's show on IG Live last week, and he had some very profound things to say in regards to George Floyd's murder in Minneapolis, Minnesota, and he took a whole lot of heat for it. We talked about it on a podcast, and I alluded to the fact that Lil Wayne at 12 years old was saved by a white cop. If you know Lil Wayne, you've heard the story many a times, giving him a different sense for the police department. Now, a lot of people were angry at Lil Wayne for what he said, for being insensitive, for being in his own world, for being in his own bubble. We gave criticism. The country gave criticism. We all heard it. Well, Lil Wayne heard it as well, and he had something to say on his podcast in regards to this incident in particular. I'm going to play what he had to say. Then I'll come back on my 1-2. Like I said, hit that like button. Make sure you hit the notification bell. Here's Lil Wayne. Let's go.
About any speculations about how I feel. Had a bunch of guests today speaking about how they feel and expressing themselves. So this is my platform. I'll speak on it. First of all, my life was saved when I was young. I was like 12 or something, I think. Shot myself. I was saved by a white cop, Uncle Bob. So you have to understand from there, for you have to understand the way I view police, period. I was saved by a white cop. There was a bunch of black cops jumped over me when they saw me at that door laying on the floor with that hole in my chest. He refused to. Those black cops jumped over me and ran through the crib and said, "We found a gun. We found this. We found that." He said, "I found this baby on this floor. I need to get to a hospital." He didn't wait for an ambulance. He took his car. He made somebody drive it. And he made sure that I lived. Now that's Uncle Bob and Uncle Bob's story. I'm from New Orleans, 17, Holly Grove. We have a thing called Jump Out Boys, Uptown New Orleans. That's the police. They pull up on you, they already got their door cracked. They already got the door, that's why we call them Jump Out Boys. Cause soon as they you might think that's just the police car driving up the block. Nah, they about to stop, boom, and it look like, you ever seen a clown car? When a clown could pull up in a small car and like 30 of them get out the car, like 30 clowns. That's how it'd be, like one small police car pull up, but they got the door, both doors crack on both sides. Pop, soon as they stop, bam, they jump out. So many of them jump out and they ain't coming running after you to come to ask you what's your name and how you doing and how's your day. No, they're not coming and running after you for that. They don't have the door crack for nothing. And it's not like they was run, they not driving into a war or nothing. They just driving into a neighborhood. Why the doors need to be cracking? I'm not sure. But that's what we grew up going through, things like that. So when I say you want to speculate about me, consider that as well. Consider I've witnessed these type of things. Like, this is what I've witnessed, is what I grew up seeing, and what I, you know what I mean? So now I'll tell you to another situation. A couple of days ago, I'm on my plane, private plane, mind you. Thank God. I spent so much for that, and I work hard for what I'm able to spend on that. Now, I had a pilot. I pay my pilots. Obviously, it's a private plane. So I had a situation on my plane. Pilot so happens to be Caucasian. I go up there to talk to him. He tells me, "Get out of the aisle and go back to your seat." He must have thought he was flying United Airlines or something. He must have forgot that was my plane. He must have totally forgot. And I think what happened is he did forget. He forgot that. He forgot what was going on. And you know what happened, though? He had police waiting for me when we landed, waiting for my ass. But thank God the police was, they didn't forget what was going on. And they let me go ahead home. So, just so you want, before you want to speculate about anything, understand that I go through situations, too. And we all got our situations. So we don't judge no one for no reason for how or whatever. Don't judge. Do you. help out in any kind of way you want to help out, any kind of way you can. We're going to only win it together. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Young Money Radio. Thank you for tuning in, however you did. I appreciate you listening, watching. I appreciate my guests. Oh, I got to say thank you to my guests because the guests, they killed it. They killed it. I got to say thank you to my guests again. CP3, Uncle Bun, Uncle Snoop, Mayor Bowser. Shout out Brayon. Hold on, Killer Mike, Stack Jack. Shout out Brayon, Mark, for making sure the mayor called in. Appreciate that, fellas. Y'all already know. Happy birthday again. Happy birthday to Miss Brianna Taylor. Also, happy birthday, Miss Rochelle. Happy birthday, Miss Rochelle. Happy birthday, Miss Rochelle. That's like another mom to me, y'all know. Obviously, you could tell. I love Miss Rochelle. I love you, Miss Rochelle. She's been working on my videos since I was like 14 years old. Obviously, that was like 2 years ago. But, you know, love you, Miss Rochelle. Again, man, shout out everybody that tuned in and Young Money. Please, 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 y'all stay out. Everybody out there, stay safe out there. I know y'all doing what you need to do, but do it safely. Do it peacefully. Young Money Radio. Thank you.
All right, so there you have it. There's Lil Wayne's thoughts on how he feels about the situation. I think right now we just need to sit back. I dropped this on my Twitter. I said, people don't want truth right now. Everyone knows the truth, but they just want validation to their quote-unquote truth. And if you don't validate their truth, then you're wrong. We all need to just shut the hell up and listen. Just be quiet and listen. There's a lot of very hurt people out here, black and brown individuals who feel as though the police have done nothing but torture, murder, and make their lives a living nightmare since the beginning of time. And they're very correct. There's also people out here that don't understand why we're rioting, why we're protesting, why we're so angry. We need to understand that. We need to have some sort of understanding so we can have some sort of conclusion. Now, everybody don't want to be singing Kumbaya. Not everybody wants to fucking understand. We're going to have hatred throughout this world, whether we like it or not. But understanding to the people who genuinely care, even though you may not understand, you may not get it, you may ruffle some feathers, you may anger people, whatever side you may be on, understanding is the key right now. Black lives, it's no arguing. Black lives matter. We all matter. But we would not say all lives matter if black lives did matter in the eyes of America, man. That's just my 1-2. Y'all take it how you will. Y'all keep protesting. Y'all keep doing what you gotta do. Make the noise. Be heard. Let's have a change right now, man. Salute to Lil Wayne for speaking his truth. You take it how you will. Like I said, I appreciate his thoughts. I appreciate his truth. May not agree with it all the way, but I did not walk in this man's shoes. I did not live in this man's life. So I'm going to listen. I'm going to understand. Y'all take that how you want. Leave a comment in the comment section. Let me know what you think. Also, in the description box, you see links to our Twitter and our IG, which you also see up top. And make sure you subscribe to the Hip Hop Uncensored podcast, dropping content 5 days a week. The full audio versions of every interview, every segment we have, raw and uncut, are on that platform. You don't want to miss it. Make sure you subscribe to that, man. I appreciate each and every one of y'all's support. It's the Sandman, Viral Hip Hop News. I'm out of here, man. Stay safe. Peace.